Hi everyone, welcome to Dive Into Ansible. I'm James Spurin and I'm your instructor for this course. I've worked in the IT industry for over 20 years for many leading companies, including Nomura, Goldman Sachs, Dell EMC, which when I worked there was just EMC, Hitachi, Virgin Internet, and one of the first ever internet providers in the UK, Demon Internet. Whilst working, I also studied and I was one of the first to complete an online master's in software engineering at Liverpool University. Personally, I love open source and DevOps technologies, so as well as Ansible, the likes of Docker, which we'll also make use of on this course. In the open source community itself, I regularly give back. I'm the creator of XML Dataset, a library for handling XML featured on the awesome Python list. I maintain a popular Docker image for another open source software project called Hexo, a framework for creating static websites. I also contribute to a variety of open source projects, including Ansible, which of course, this course is about. The course originally started back in 2018 as Mastering Ansible, and since then it's been refreshed and updated to what you see here as Dive Into Ansible. I regularly review and maintain it, and so far it's supported Ansible right through from version 2 to the current version. With this course, I bring you a fantastic lab experience which directly mirrors what I'm actually using in the lessons, where Ansible and all of the associated lab hosts are directly accessible from your web browser. You can run this locally on your own system or via Google Cloud. You get your Ansible Control Host, free Ubuntu, and free CentOS systems. We intentionally use different Linux systems so that we can really see the power and versatility of Ansible when targeting these systems simultaneously. By the way, in this course, the container images and the environment that I've created for the lab are also open sourced, so these are also available for you to use yourself or even just for learning purposes. Personally, I now focus full-time on education and content as the founder of this company, Dive Into, and especially love hearing and connecting with people like yourselves who clearly share the same interests in technology. For whatever reason you've decided to learn Ansible today, take a moment and connect with me on both Twitter and LinkedIn. This course is provided with a huge library of examples that relate to each chapter and has been designed so that you can actually work through this in the best way that suits you. Rather than me actually dictating how you should learn, you can actually choose your own preferred learning path. So you can just watch through the videos if you rapidly need to learn Ansible in a short amount of time. Alternatively, you can follow the course and directly run and interact with all of the examples yourselves in exactly the same way that I'm using throughout the course. Or, again, you can use the content as a reference and create your own content based on what is taught. Regardless of which approach you choose, at the end, you'll also have a full library of resources that you can make use of for when you're using Ansible. So, onto the course content. We're currently in the first section, and after this overview, we'll start with an introduction to Ansible. Next, we'll install Docker, which is a requirement for our lab environment. We'll configure the Ansible lab. We'll set up a trusted relationship between our hosts with SSH, and we'll configure the course code repository. In section 3, we'll look at Ansible architecture and design. We'll start by configuring Ansible, where we'll make use of the awesome Ansible command line tool to validate and test our configuration. We'll also look at inventories and modules and how we can interact with modules direct from the command line. In section 4, we'll get started with playbooks. We'll take a look at YAML, the various sections that make up a playbook, the use of variables and facts, how to use templating with Jinja 2, and we'll create and execute a fully fledged web server and website project with Ansible. In section 5, we'll take a look at some of the more common playbook modules. We'll look at dynamic inventories, both how to use them and how to create them. The use of register and when for capturing information. The various ways of using loops. We'll look at the performance aspects with different means of execution such as asynchronous, serial, and parallel. Task delegation, i.e. how to make a task run on a specific target. Ansible's magic variables, Ansible blocks, and the Ansible vault for securing information. In section 6, we'll see how we can structure Ansible playbooks through the use of includes and imports. Tags that will allow us to reuse specific entities and roles where we can break our tasks into reusable components. In section 7, we'll make use of popular areas with Ansible, such as AWS and Docker. In section 8, we'll create our own modules and plugins. Section 9 covers other Ansible resources and areas such as troubleshooting. Lastly, section 10 is supplementary, and within this are other areas and resources that you may find useful. So, with that introduction and summary, let's dive into the next video, Introduction to Ansible.